It's time for a quick geography lesson. There's a city in Canada called Winnipeg. This city gave a whopping $9 million in budget to fix potholes alone just for this year. And this budget only increases after every winter. You see, when cities have extreme weather conditions in the winter, like Winnipeg, which actually had a day that it was colder than the surface of Mars, the concrete that was laid out on the road isn't meant to withstand such freezing temperatures. Some of the main causes of broken concrete are normal wear and tear that can actually make the material lose its sealing and waterproof quality over the years, which in turn causes cracks and water infiltration. When winter rolls around, the water turns into ice and expands. Once the weather starts to warm up and the ice melts, there are even bigger cracks that are left in the pavement, which leads to vicious potholes that cost millions of dollars in annual city budgets to fix. Not to mention, this is also why your house foundation starts to crack after a certain amount of years. There is a solution to this issue, though, that's pretty interesting and also environmentally friendly. As we know, regular concrete has a massive carbon footprint, so technologies that boost its performance and enable it to last longer could have compounding benefits over the course of years for the environment. This has led to the development of self-healing concrete that can repair its own cracks. The newest type of this souped-up concrete makes use of an enzyme found in human blood. Crazy, right? Tiny cracks that form in concrete might not pose an immediate problem to the structural integrity of a construction or road, but as water gets in, it ruptures, spreads, and can greatly compromise its strength. The idea behind self-healing concrete is to intervene in this process while the cracks are still tiny, sealing up the material to prevent not just an entire collapse, but expensive maintenance or complete replacement of the concrete. There have been many interesting and creative types of self-healing concrete made in the past decade. We've seen versions that pack their own sodium silicate healing agents, ones that feature bacteria that produce special glue to knit together these cracks, and others that fill up the gaps with a natural fungus. While all of these solutions sound promising, the Worcester Polytechnic Institute have created what they believe is a cheaper and a potentially more efficient solution. The team gained inspiration from the human body of all things, more specifically from the way an enzyme in the red blood cells called carbonic anhydrase, short form CA, which was able to quickly transfer CO2 from the cells to the bloodstream. We looked at nature to find what triggers the fastest CO2 transfer, and that's the CA enzyme, says study author Nima Rabar. Since enzymes in our body react amazingly quickly, they can be used as an efficient mechanism to repair and strengthen concrete structures. The team put the CA enzyme to use by adding it to concrete powder before the material is mixed and poured. When a small crack forms in the concrete, the enzyme interacts with CO2 in the air to produce calcium carbonate crystals, which mimic the characteristics of concrete and promptly fill in the crack. Through their testing, the researchers demonstrated their steroided concrete can repair its own millimeter-sized cracks within 24 hours. Pretty incredible. The team says this is a marked improvement on some previous technologies that have used bacteria to self-heal, which are more expensive and can take up to a month to heal for even smaller cracks. While the amount of CO2 the concrete gobbles up is likely negligible to the grand scheme of things, the real environmental potential of the material lies within its potential longevity. They predict this type of self-healing technology could extend the life of a structure from 20 years to 80 years, which reduces the need to produce replacement concrete in someone's lifetime. Building concrete structures or roads is also a notoriously carbon-intensive process. A recent estimate said the material is responsible for 9% of global CO2 emissions, which is more than 3 times of the airline industry. 9% might not sound like a lot, but when you put it on a global scale, it's a massive number. To put this into perspective, if the concrete industry was a country, it would be the 3rd largest climate polluter in the world. Healing traditional concrete that's already in use is critically beneficial too, and it will help us reduce the need to produce and ship additional concrete, which has a huge environmental impact. Recent peer-reviewed studies showed how the process worked in cement, which is the glue that holds the concrete together. Rabar hopes one day somebody will license the technology to bring it to market in use for roads, sidewalks, buildings, and other structures. It could make our concrete last 4 times longer than usual. The industry might be slow to adopt the change because things are working fine as they are right now, but policy and a show of reduced costs could help. This is not going to cost much, Rebar says, but overall the system requires some incentive. What are your thoughts on self-healing concrete? Do you think it's important enough to go through to mass market? Let us know in the comment section below. In the meantime, don't forget to like this video and subscribe so you don't miss any other tech videos. Thanks for watching and see you next time.